All right. Well, good evening, everyone. Thank you for tuning in, and thank you for watching another week of Classic Country A to Z. Tonight, we continue yet again with the Merle Haggard collection. And I was thinking last week that maybe we might finish this week with Merle Haggard's songs, but it turns out we won't finish them until next week. And in fact, more than half of next week's show will be Merle Haggard still. So, but as always, there'll be an original song in the middle and a gospel song at the end. So I ended last week's show with Merle's 27th number one hit called My Favorite Memory, which was the first release off of his 1981 album entitled Big City, the second number one hit off that album. And Merle's 28th number one hit in his career was the title track to that album, and it's our first song tonight. This song actually has kind of a bit of an interesting backstory to it. It turns out the song was inspired by a remark that Merle's lifelong friend and tour bus driver, Dean Holloway, made at the end of a packed two-day recording session in L.A. Merle went to the bus to check on Holloway, who had been minding the bus, and Merle asked him how he was doing, and Holloway responded, "I hate this place. I'm tired of this dirty old city." And Merle immediately saw inspiration and began writing the song based on Holloway's remark on a nearby pad of paper, and Holloway's line of "I'm tired of this dirty old city" became the song's first line. And then Merle decided that the chorus should include the narrator talking about moving elsewhere, and so he asked Holloway where he would rather be, to which Holloway responded, "If it were up to me, I'd be somewhere in the middle of Montana." And so, somewhere in the middle of Montana became part of the chorus for the song. Merle rushed back into the studio where the band was already packing up and told them to unpack their instruments in order to record one last song. The band recorded this song in one take with no rehearsals, and that was the recording that became the number one hit. In the end, Merle credited Holloway as a co-writer of this number one hit song, entitling Holloway to half the royalties of the song, which amounted to roughly about $500,000 for him. This song is called Big City. I'm tired of this dirty old city, entirely too much work and never enough play. And I'm tired of these dirty old sidewalks, think I'll walk off my steady job today. So turn me loose, set me free, somewhere in the middle of Montana, and give me all I got coming to me, and keep your retirement and your so-called Social Security. Big city, turn me loose and set me free. I've been working every day since I was 20. Haven't got a thing to show for anything I've done. Well, there's folks who never work and they've got plenty. I think it's time some guys like me had some fun. So turn me loose, set me free, somewhere in the middle of Montana, and give me all I got coming to me. and keep your retirement and your so-called Social Security. Big city turned me loose and set me free. A big city turned me loose and set me free. Okay, next up, another big city album song that Merle wrote and released. This one in 1982. The song went to number 2 on the charts for him and was described by music reviews as, quote, "The theme of the song is the concern over irreversible moral decay." Kind of a downer overall, but the closing lines express optimism, so it's not all doom and gloom. This song is called "Are the Good Times Really Over for Good?" I wish a buck was still silver, it was back when the country was strong. It was back before Elvis, before the Vietnam War came along. Before the Beatles and Yesterday, when a man could still work and still would. Well, is the best of the free life behind us now? And are the good times really over for good? Are we rolling downhill like a snowball headed for hell? Chance for the flag or the Liberty Bell. I wish a Ford and a Chevy would still last 10 years like they should. Is the best of the free life behind us now? And are the good times really over? Good. I wish Coke was still cola and a joint was a bad place to be. And it was back before Nixon lied to us all on TV. Before microwave ovens, when a girl could still cook and still would. Is the best of the free life behind us now? And are the good times really over for good? Are we rolling downhill like a snowball? Headed for hell. With no kind of chance for the flag or the Liberty Bell. I wish a Ford and a Chevy would still last 10 years like they should. Is the best of the free life behind us now? And are the good times really over for good? Stop rolling downhill like a snowball headed for hell. Stand up for the
the flag and let's all ring the Liberty Bell. Let's make a Ford and a Chevy, it'll still last 10 years like they should. 'Cause the best of the free life is still yet to come, and the good times ain't over for good. Yeah, the best of the free life is still yet to come, and the good times ain't over for good.
Okay, next up, I should check comments here. Mary Pat and Craig, thank you both for tuning in. Okay, next was Merle's 28th number one hit. This one also from 1982. Another song that he wrote himself and made the title track to his last 1982 album. The song and the album are called Going Where the Lonely Go.
All around, I've got to keep going, traveling down this lonesome road. I'm rolling with the flow, going where the lonely go. I've got to keep going, I can't lay down, sleep won't hardly come, when there's loneliness all around. I've got to keep going, traveling down this lonesome road. I'm rolling with the flow, going where the lonely go. Yeah, I'm just rolling with the flow, going where the lonely go.
Okay, now, the next single that Merle released from that Going Where the Lonely Go album became his 29th number one hit. Although this one was written by Leona Williams, his wife at the time, it was his last big hit in 1982, and the song is called You Take Me For Granted. Thank you.
my legs and my feet have walked till they can't hardly move from trying to please you. And my back is sore from bending over backwards to just lay the world at your door. I try so hard to keep a smile on a sad face while deep down it's breaking my heart. And as sure as the sun shines, I'll be a lifetime not knowing if I've done my part. 'Cause you take me for granted, and it's breaking my heart. And as sure as the sun shines, I'll be a lifetime not knowing if I've done my part. Sunshines, I'll be a lifetime not knowing if I've done my part. Just as sure as the sun shines, I'll be a lifetime not knowing if I've done my part.
Okay, now, next one is the first song he wrote and released as a single from his first 1983 album, entitled That's the Way Love Goes. The song climbed all the way to number 3 in the charts for him, and this one's called What Am I Gonna Do? I can make it for a day or two without you, and maybe I can make it through the night. I can light and I can drink and probably be all right until morning. What am I gonna do with the rest of my life? Well, I got things that I can do. I got places I can go to this evening. I got whiskey I can drink that can help me not to think about your leaving. Yeah, I can smoke
smoke and I can drink, it'd probably be all right until morning. But what am I gonna do with the rest of my life? Yeah, I got things that I can do, I got places I can go to this evening. And I've got whiskey I can drink that can help me not to think about your leaving. Yeah, I can smoke and I can drink, it'd probably be all right until morning. But what am I gonna do with the rest of my life? Oh, what am I gonna do with the rest of my life?
Okay, now this next song actually is a pop song whose most successful version was recorded by Tommy Edwards in 1958 when he had a number one hit on the pop charts with it. A man by the name of Carl Sigman wrote the lyrics in 1951, which was 40 years after the music, entitled Melody in A Major, was written by Charles Dawes in 1911. Charles Dawes was later Vice President of the United States under Calvin Coolidge, and it was the only number one single in U.S. history to have been co-written by a U.S. Vice President or a Nobel Peace Prize laureate, for that matter, which Dawes also was. The song ranked at number 47 in the 2018 Billboard list of the Hot 100's all-time top songs, and it's become a pop standard with cover versions by dozens of artists over the years, including Merle Haggard, whose 1983 release only rose to number 54 on the charts. But I've always liked this song, and Merle was the only classic country artist that I know of who covered it and released it. So this song is called It's All in the Game. Many a tear has to fall, but it's all in the game. All in the wonderful game that we know as love. You had words with him, and your future's looking dim. But these things your heart can rise above. Once in a while he won't call, but it's all in the game. Soon he'll be there by your side with a sweet bouquet, and he'll kiss your lips and caress your waiting fingertips.
and your heart will fly away. You had words with him, and your future's looking dim. But these things your heart can rise above. Once in a while he won't call, but it's all in the game. And soon he'll be there by your side with a sweet bouquet. And he'll kiss your lips and caress your waiting fingertips. And your heart will fly away.
All right. Looks like that was popular. Someday I'll have to do a collection of just 50s songs. Got a lot to get through before we get there, though. Okay, next up. This is a song that was a number one hit and title track for several classic country artists, except for the classic country artist who wrote it. The song was written by Lefty Frizzell, and one night at Nashville's Continental Inn in late 1973, Johnny Rodriguez was involved in what's called a guitar pull, which is a Nashville ritual in which songwriters gather around in a circle and pass one guitar around, and each writer would sing the new songs they'd written. And along with Johnny Rodriguez, the attendees in this particular guitar pull circle included Dallas Frazier, Merle Haggard, Merle's manager, Louis Talley, Whitey Schaefer, and Lefty Frizzell. And the session apparently was about to break up, and everyone started to get ready to leave when Lefty said he wanted to play just one more song. It was this next song, and Merle wanted it right then, but he just finished an album and didn't have any more studio time scheduled. So the next day, Whitey Schaefer brought the song down to the studio where Johnny Rodriguez was recording, and Johnny snapped it up and recorded it, which resulted in his third consecutive number one hit in early 1974. Merle actually recorded the song like four or five times through the years before he finally got a version that he liked. And then finally in 1983, 10 years after Johnny Rodriguez had his big hit, the song became Merle's 30th number one hit, and it won him a Grammy Award that year. It was also the title track to his album, and so the song and the album are called That's the Way Love Goes.
I've been throwing horseshoes over my left shoulder. I've spent most all my life searching for that four-leaf clover. Yet you ran with me, chasing my rainbow. And honey, I love you too, and that's the way love goes. Well, that's the way love goes, babe. That's the music God made for all the world to sing. It's never old, it grows. Losing makes me sorry. And you say, honey, now don't worry. Don't you know I love you too? And that's the way love goes. That's the way love goes, babe. That's the music God made for the whole wide world to sing. It's never old, it grows. Losing makes me sorry. And you say, honey, now don't worry. Don't you know I love you too? That's the way love goes. Honey, I love you too. And that's the way love goes.
Okay, that's a classic for sure. Now, Merle's next number one hit is off that same That's the Way Love Goes album, and was written by Merle and his wife, Leona Williams. This song is called Someday When Things Are Good.
Someday when things are good, I'm gonna leave you. I can't seem to go when things are bad. I'll be one more love that you can dream about, and one more man that you can say you've had. You'll always be the kind to dream of yesterday, and a way of life I never understood. And someday soon I'll be just one more memory, and you'll call my name when things are not so good. Someday when things are good, I'm gonna leave you. I can't seem to go when things are bad. Well, I'll be one more love that you can dream about, and one more man that you can say you've had. Yeah, I'll be one more man that you can say you've had.
Okay, so we've reached the portion of the show where I do one of the original songs that my friend Charlie and I wrote. The song's about finding an old love letter from a prior relationship and wondering what if. The song is called Haunted by Your Dreams. Thank you.
Found a letter from you I thought I'd thrown away. It brought back thoughts of you I thought were gone to stay. Thoughts of you and me, of our destiny, of the love you threw away. I read your words again, the ones you wrote that day. You said your love was strong, a love that was here to stay. And love for you and me, for what we could be, now that love had come our way. All your hopes and dreams, all your fantasies, were right there on the page. A promise from your hand that our love would stand and nothing would ever change. But things change somehow, those words haunt me now, like whispers in the trees, never leaving me, always keeping me haunted by your dreams. You promised that no one could steal your heart away. And you promised someday you'd be back to stay. That it would always be just you and me, and soon we'd be on our way. But you never came back, not once since that day. Left me feeling so lost, feeling so betrayed. No more you and me, no more destiny, no more words left to say. 'Cause all your hopes and dreams, all your fantasies, were right there on the page. A promise from your hand that our love would stand and nothing would ever change. But things change somehow, those words haunt me now, like whispers in the trees, never leaving me, always keeping me haunted by your dreams. Can I hold you to those words, words from your own pen? Can I hold you to those dreams and hold you close again? I folded up your words and hid your dreams away, leaving thoughts of you for some other rainy day. Thoughts of you and me, of what used to be, when our love was here to stay. Yeah, all your hopes and dreams, all your fantasies, were right there on the page. A promise from your hand that our love would stand and nothing would ever change. But things change somehow, those words haunt me now, like whispers in the trees, never leaving me, always keeping me haunted by your dreams. Never leaving me, always keeping me haunted by your dreams.
Okay, now, back to Merle Haggard. In late 1984, Merle released this next song as a duet with Janie Fricke, and it rose to number one on the charts. Merle co-wrote this song with Willie Nelson and Freddie Powers, and this song is called A Place to Fall Apart.
I'll probably never see you eye to eye again. This letter's meant to be my last farewell. But you need to understand I'm nearly crazy. You need to know my life has gone to hell. Write me back and tell me why it ended. Send a letter that I can show my heart. I'll be somewhere between I love you and what you're feeling now. Looking for a place to fall apart. Looking for a place to fall apart. Trying to find a place where I can leave my heart. I need to be somewhere hiding when I feel teardrops start. Looking for a place to fall apart. Well, I can't seem to justify your leaving me. I'm bewildered as to how it all came down. I thought everything was fine until your phone call. The call that turned my world around. Send me word and tell me why it ended. I need some final proof to show my heart. I'll be somewhere between I love you and what you're feeling now. Looking for a place to fall apart. Looking for a place to fall apart. Trying to find a place that I can leave my heart. I need to be somewhere hiding when I feel the teardrops start. Looking for a place to fall apart. Looking for a place to fall apart.
Okay. Merle's 33rd number one hit was released in early 1985, and this song was written by Freddie Powers, the co-writer on the previous song. Also in this song, Janie Fricke did the backup harmonies, and this song is called Natural High. You stayed with me through thick and thin. You watched me lose, you watched me win. You picked me up off of the ground. You never one time let me down. And you put me on a natural high. And I can fly, I can fly. I was drowning in a sea of make-believe, as helpless as a falling leaf. You gave your hand to me that day, and you did it 'cause you're made that way. And you put me on a natural high. And I can fly, I can fly.
You always seem to let your feelings show. You love me and you let me know. Well, darling, just remember these three words. I love you, I love you, I love you. You put me on a natural high, and I can fly, I can fly. Yeah, you put me on a natural high, and I can fly, I can fly.
All right. Sorry, Gail, these are some slow songs tonight. I don't know, a lot of these artists, they get later in their careers and they just more seem to slow down a little bit. So next one, Merle wrote and released this next song later in 1985, rose to number 10 on the charts for him. This song grimly recounts the story of the singer's girlfriend's drowning. In the 2013 biography entitled Merle Haggard, The Running Kind, the biography writer David Cantwell calls this song, quote, a scary record that screamed quiet and startled you alive. Not sure what all was meant there. But anyway, this song is called Kern River. Swim Kern River again. It was there that I met her. It was there that I lost my best friend. And now I live in the mountains. I drifted up here with the wind. And I may drown in still water, but I'll never swim Kern River again. I grew up in oil town, but my gusher never came in. And the river was a boundary where my darling and I used to swim. One night in the moonlight, the swiftness swept her life away. Now I live on Lake Shasta, and Lake Shasta is where I will stay. Well, there's a South San Joaquin where the seeds of the Dust Bowl are found. And there's a place called Mount Whitney from where the mighty Kern River comes down. Well, it's not deep nor wide, but it's a mean piece of water, my friend. And I may cross on the highway, but I'll never swim Kern River again. No, I'll never swim Kern River again. It was there that I met her. It was there that I lost my best friend. And now I live in the mountains. I drifted up here with the wind. And I may drown in still water, but I'll never swim Kern River again. Yeah, I may drown in still water, but I'll never swim Kern River again. Okay. Merle wrote and released this next song in early 1986, and it rose to number 5 on the charts for him that year. Little more up-tempo song finally, so this one is called I've Had a Beautiful Time.
Downtown in a bar room, both of us needing a friend. You brought me home to your doorstep. It was there you invited me in. And we spent the wee hours dancing to your favorite home stereo sound. We talked about what we've been needing, discussing our ups and our downs. And I've had a beautiful time holding your heart next to mine. I poured out the feelings while you poured the wine, and I've had a beautiful time. Well, if I seem a wee bit uneasy, you really sized me up right. There's somebody home still up waiting, probably been waiting up all night. I can't say I found any answers, but you listen while I rattle on. And you, little beautiful lady, and you kept me from being alone. And I've had a beautiful time holding your heart next to mine. You poured out the feelings while you poured the wine, and I've had a beautiful time. Yeah, I've had a beautiful time holding your heart next to mine. We poured out the feelings while we poured the wine. I've had a beautiful time. Yeah, we poured out the feelings while we poured the wine. And I've had a beautiful time.
Okay, felt good to pick it up a little bit there. So this next one is another song written by Freddie Powers, and Merle released it in 1986 as the title track and second single from his album that year. The song reached number 9 on the charts, and the song and the album are called Friend in California.
L.A. traffic is bad this time of year, but there's a friend of yours in California sure wishes you were here. And as you lay your head on your pillow tonight, just remember there's a friend of yours in California sure misses you. You've got a friend in California that misses you. You've got a friend in California that sure misses you. Fort Worth sure can get cold this time of year, but this Southern California sun is warm. You should be here. As you lay your head on your pillow tonight, just remember there's a friend of yours in California sure misses you. You've got a friend in California that misses you. You've got a friend in California that sure misses you. Yeah, you got a friend in California that misses you. You've got a friend in California that sure misses you.
Oops, missed the last chord. That's going to happen. Okay, next up, this is Merle's 34th and last number one hit as a solo artist. He had four more number one hits as duets. Merle co-wrote this song with Freddie Powers and released it in 1987. And this song is called Twinkle, Twinkle, Lucky Star.
Twinkle, twinkle, lucky star, can you send me luck from where you are? Can you make a rainbow shine that far? Twinkle, twinkle, lucky star, can you really make a wish come true? And do you shine on just a chosen few? Is it over? Have I gone too far? Twinkle, twinkle, lucky star. Like two ships on the ocean, we drifted apart, and you found an island at sea. I'm still adrift with this pain in my heart. Won't you send her sweet love back to me? Hey, twinkle, twinkle, lucky star, can you send me luck from where you are? Can you make a rainbow shine that far? Twinkle, twinkle, lucky star. Like two ships on the ocean, we drifted apart, and you found an island at sea. I'm still adrift with this pain in my heart. Won't you send her sweet love back to me? Hey, twinkle, twinkle, lucky star, can you send me luck from where you are? Can you make a rainbow shine that far? Twinkle, twinkle, lucky star. Twinkle, twinkle, lucky star.
All right. How are we doing on time? Oh my gosh, it's already 8 o'clock. Okay, we're going to do one more Merle Haggard song for tonight, and then we will jump to the gospel. So we're going to close tonight's Merle Haggard collection with a one of his duet hits. Merle and Willie Nelson released a duet album back in 1982 called Poncho and Lefty. And the first release from that album was this next song that Merle wrote. The song reached number 6 on the charts for them, and this one's called Reasons to Quit.
Reasons to quit. The smoke and beer don't do me like before. And I'm hardly ever sober. My old friends don't come around much anymore. And reasons to quit, the low is always lower than the high. And the reasons for quitting don't outnumber all the reasons why. So we keep smoking and we keep drinking, having fun and never thinking, laughing at the price tags that we pay. And we keep roaring down the fast lane like two young men feeling no pain. And the reasons for quitting are getting bigger each day. Reasons to quit. I can't afford the habit all the time. And I need to be sober. I gotta write some new songs that will rhyme. Reasons to quit. There ain't no rhyme or reason when you're high. And the reasons for quitting don't outnumber all the reasons why. So we keep smoking and we keep drinking, having fun and never thinking, laughing at the price tags that we pay. And we keep roaring down the fast lane like two young men feeling no pain. And the reasons for quitting are getting bigger each day. Yeah, the reasons for quitting are getting bigger each day.
Okay, we will jump to the gospel song for tonight. There's some dispute about the authorship of this hymn. The lyrics are believed to be written by a preacher riding on a train in 1911. It turns out the guy sitting next to him on the train was a gospel music promoter who thought the lyrics were great, and so he paid the preacher $2 for the lyrics, and then later had them put to music. The song deals with the Christian's dismay at the apparent prosperity of the wicked when contrasted with the suffering of the righteous. The repeated theme is that farther along, presumably in heaven, the truth will be revealed. And so tonight's hymn is called Farther Along.
Tempted and tried, we're oft made to wonder why it should be thus all the day long. While there are others living about us, never though in the wrong, when death has come and taken our loved ones, leaving our home so lonely and drear, then do we wonder others prosper. living so wicked year after year. Farther along we'll know all about it. Farther along we'll understand why. Cheer up, my brothers, live in the sunshine. Yeah, we'll understand it all by and by. When we see Jesus coming in glory, when he comes down from his home in the sky, well, then we shall meet him in that bright mansion, and we'll understand it all by and by. Well, farther along we'll know all about it, and farther along we'll understand why. Well, cheer up, my brothers, live in the sunshine. Yeah, we'll understand it all by and by. Oh, we'll understand it all by and by.
Okay, which takes us to our benediction.
May the good Lord bless and keep you, whether near or far away. May you find that long-awaited golden day today. May your troubles all be small ones, and your fortune 10 times 10. May the good Lord bless and keep you till we meet again. May you walk with sunlight shining and a bluebird in every tree. May there be a silver lining back of every cloud you see. Fill your dreams with sweet tomorrows, never mind what might have been. May the good Lord bless and keep you till we meet again. May you walk with sunlight shining and a bluebird in every tree. May there be a silver lining back of every cloud you see. Fill your dreams with sweet tomorrows, never mind what might have been. May the good Lord bless and keep you till we meet again. May the good Lord bless and keep you till we meet again.
So ends our another week of Classic Country A to Z. Thank you for tuning in. Let's see, look at the comments. Craig and Mary Pat and Gail, thank you. You're welcome, and thank you. Next week, we will continue with Merle Haggard, but we will finish Merle Haggard next week. So I'm not exactly sure who's next right after him, but and more than half of the show next week will be Merle Haggard still. So anyway, have a great night. Have a great week. Try and stay warm if you're here in the north half of the hemisphere, north part of the country. We're in for a cold week here in Minnesota, so we'll just hunker down and stay warm. And stay safe, and we will see you next Sunday. Good night, everybody. Thanks.